name is Dr. Ohene Kwabena Safo. I'm the CEO for OKS Medical Consult. I'm a medical officer at Pantine Hospital Medical OPD Unit and a researcher into plant medicine at Kantan Kasunyaye. So we're talking about mental health and emotional wellness today. And in general, health is a complete state of physical, mental and social well-being, not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. This makes you understand that health is paramount as far as holistic healthcare is concerned. And mental health is very pivotal in our lives. We know that yearly we have about 800,000 people committing suicide. And this leaves us with sufferers or a burden of around 108 million people suffering because of the demise of these people. And the burden of mental health is huge. Depression is also really affecting our population. We have around 650,000 people suffering from severe depression, with about 2.1 million people having mild to moderate depression. This makes us understand that there's a need for us to take a critical look at mental health illnesses. I would say, in general, mental health has a trilogic relationship in terms of what causes it. And we take it from host factors, we have environmental factors, and we have what we call the agents. With host factors, you are looking at your hereditary potential, genetics. Some people are naturally predisposed to getting depression and schizophrenia. Again, aside our host factors, we look at what we call the environmental factors, which I call the triggers or the precipitating factors, things that could tip you off or trigger a mental health illness. We have loss of a loved one, divorce. It could be from you being actually sacked from work or losing your job. It could be from breakup. And we have what we call the agents, which is the third part of the trilogic relationship. So with agents, we are looking at people who have suffered head injury before, people who have mental health illnesses from a possible meningitis that happened earlier on, persons who had maybe cerebral malaria earlier on, people doing drugs, people taking alcohol. All these things are agents that could predispose or precipitate a mental health illness. When you take depression in general, there are signs and symptoms that people with depression show up, which we should all pay attention to and look out for. Some of which include depressed mood. So people with depression show depressed mood. So they are not happy in general. They are depressed. Two, anhedonia. So there's loss of interest in what really makes them happy. So persons with depression lose interest in things that used to motivate them. Okay. Again, they have sleep problems. So either they sleep too much or they are not able to sleep at all. They also have appetite problems. Either they are eating too much or they are not able to eat at all. They have poor concentration. They are not able to concentrate very well. Some have guilty feelings. They feel ill for things they've not even done. All these are some of the symptoms that people with depression shows up. So if you see or identify anybody going through or any of their symptoms, it's actually a red flag for you to call a doctor or visit a doctor. So in general, what I would like to say is mental health is part of us. There is actually the need for us to seek help as early as possible, because early detection and diagnosis comes with good outcome.